Subscribe and click the bell icon for the latest updates and notifications from the Indian Express.
On June 16th, after a surprise reshuffle in the Pakistan Army, Lieutenant General Faiz Hameed became the new Director General of the Inter-Services Intelligence, or ISI, replacing Lieutenant General Asim Munir, whose tenure lasted for just 8 months. ISI, Pakistan's military-led spy agency, holds immense sway over the country's national politics and foreign policy, shaping Pakistan's mullah-military alliance. So while Prime Minister Imran Khan may have appointed Hameed in consultation with Pakistan Army Chief General Bajwa, the ISI chief will be answerable only to the latter. Before Hameed became ISI chief, he ran the internal security wing of the intelligence agency. He made headlines in November 2017 after successfully brokering a deal to end a 22-day-long sit-in protest in Islamabad by Tariq-e-Labbaik protesters. Brokered by the army, the Faizabad agreement names Lieutenant General Hameed as the guarantor.
They were protesting a change in the Elections Act, which they said had actually diluted the very draconian anti-Ahmadiyya and anti-blasphemy laws. They didn't want that change. And the civilian government had no way to disperse the protesters. And the siege continued for a long time until the army stepped in again to negotiate an end to the protest. Lieutenant General Hameed was at that time in the ISI, and he was a major general then. He was heading internal security operations, and his signature is on that agreement. He is the guarantor of that agreement.
During the 2018 elections in Pakistan, former PM Nawaz Sharif accused him of engineering defections from the PML Nawaz to Imran Khan's PTI. Hailing from Baloch regiment like General Bajwa, Hameed's impending rise was signalled in April 2019 when he was promoted, becoming a three-star general. His appointment has come months before General Bajwa's three-year term as army chief comes to an end in November 2019. By 2022, Hameed will become among the top favourites in line to become the next army chief. As ISI chief, Hameed will be instrumental in not only running the country, but also managing its foreign policy, including Pakistan's relations with India. How Hameed directs ISI's relationship with the India-focused terrorist groups, Masood Azhar-led Jaish-e-Mohammed and Hafiz Saeed-led Lashkar-e-Taiba, will be under scrutiny.
After the incident in February, on February 14th, when the Jaish claimed this huge attack in Pulwama, in which there was a suicide bombing on a CRPF convoy and 40 Jawan were killed. And then India responded some days later with an airstrike inside Pakistan in Balakot. This is seen to have somewhat changed the India-Pakistan dynamic, especially in Kashmir. And India will be waiting to see how the new ISI chief negotiates that change.
Hameed's appointment comes when there is a turmoil in northwest Pakistan from the protesting Pashtun Tahfuz movement, who've been called terrorists and anti-nationals, allegedly in the pay of Indian intelligence agencies by the Pakistani army. Pakistan Army has declared that it will not tolerate dissent, and the newly appointed ISI chief will be the one to implement that rule.